Mr. President, Mr. Secretary General, allow me to first express my sincere appreciation to you, Mr. President, for organizing today's special session to pay tribute to His Majesty King Bhumibol Adulyadej, and for your statement of condolences. We also deeply appreciate the kind and touching statements made by His Excellency the Secretary General, the distinguished chairs of regional groups, and the distinguished permanent representative of the United States of America, our host country. Mr. President, His Majesty King Bhumibol was the guiding light of Thailand. Through the many crises and challenges the kingdom had to face in the last 7 decades, His Majesty was always there for his people, giving them soul, resilience, and most important of all, direction. He was a symbol of our national unity, sustaining the kingdom's cultural and social integrity, providing spiritual and material foundation on which Thai people from all walks of life built their livelihood. From the early years of his reign, His Majesty had this vision of people-centered development. His Majesty reached out with the aim of leaving no one behind. Through more than 4,000 royal development projects, His Majesty empowered the poorest and the most vulnerable, improved the livelihood, and provided opportunity for the people to prosper, and promoted peaceful society that is mindful of the environment. His Majesty guided the way for transforming the kingdom from what was commonly called an underdeveloped country into the upper middle income country that it is now. Mr. President, His Majesty Queen Bhumibol was no stranger to the United Nations. Twice in the 1960s, he made official visits to the UN headquarters here in New York and shared with the Secretary General his insights on tackling pressing global issues. His Majesty's pioneer work on crop substitution and integrated rural development, started in the early 1960s, has over the years been praised by the UN Office on Drugs and Crimes as an effective means to eradicate illicit drug production. The work has indeed developed into the now globally recognized concept of alternative development, which has successfully turned countless opium poppy fields in many countries around the world into horticulture plantations, handicraft and vocational training centers, or even tourist attractions. The UN and its specialized agencies on numerous occasions recognize His Majesty's role as a development king through his contribution to improving people's lives, rural development, food security, and his lifelong dedication to the cause of sustainable development, thus presenting His Majesty with the FAO's Agricola Medal in 1995, the UN Habitat Score of Honor Special Citation Award in 2003, the first ever UNDP Human Development Lifetime Achievement Award in 2006, and the WIPO Global Leader Award in 2009. In recognition of his research and development work on soils, His Majesty's birthday, the 5th of December, has been designated World Soil Day by the General Assembly since 2014. His Majesty's countless efforts in working side by side with grassroots people, farmers and communities, and thousands of royal development projects throughout Thailand for decades have crystallized into what is now known as the philosophy of sufficiency economy. This latest gift bestowed on the Thai people by His Majesty advocates moderation, reasonableness, and prudence based on knowledge and virtues as way of life and decision-making framework. Acknowledged as a practical approach to achieving sustainable development, the philosophy has been successfully practiced in Thailand and many other countries in both agricultural and business sectors, as well as in public administration. We are proud to have been able to share this gift with our friends here at the United Nations over the years. Monsieur le Président, nous sommes confiants que de nombreux héritages de Sa Majesté, le roi Bhumibol, en particulier la philosophie de l'économie de suffisance, continueront à guider la Thaïlande et nos amis dans notre quête commune pour atteindre les objectifs de développement durable à l'horizon 2030. Au nom du peuple thaïlandais et du gouvernement royal de Thaïlande, permettez-moi d'exprimer une fois de plus notre profonde gratitude et notre appréciation la plus sincère.